There's a great sense of peace about that piece of music. And of course, that's what today is about, getting a sense of peace and knowing that Rose is now in a very special, a very happy place after journeying through life in a very positive and in a very caring and loving fashion. And we couldn't even comprehend the changes that this woman has seen in the decades of her life. Probably safe to say that no other generation of people will ever see as changes as vast as what has taken place over Rose and her peers' lifetime. Today we're coming to celebrate her life and give thanks to God for her achievements and for successes and all that has been part and parcel of that great earthly journey. I welcome you joining me here today, and particularly Ita Martin and Jarlath and members of family, and all who are joining us on Parish Radio and on webcam. Because of restrictions, we know that it is difficult on every family, and naturally there will be situations where people cannot travel to be here for what should be a family gathering, especially one of the most sensitive times in family life. And I want to, in a very special way, remember and bring with us into the liturgy today those who cannot be here due to COVID travel restrictions, and especially your nephews and great-grandsons, Ivor and Louise and Xander in Canada, and Connor and Hannah in the UK, and Johnny and Einar in Iceland, and distant relatives, friends, neighbours, and people in the community and further afield, those who are joining us through webcam. We're celebrating, as I pre-mentioned, a great life. And today we honour that with our thanksgiving to God in this Mass, a Mass that was very central to her in her life. And for her achievements in community and in church, she was presented something very special, very prestigious in her day, and that is, of course, the Benemerente Medal presented from the Pope, Pope John Paul II, back some years ago. So it's very fitting that Fionn, her grandson, would now place that medal on the coffin as we celebrate in thanksgiving today for her life. And we prepare ourselves now to celebrate the Mass just like every other occasion as we come before God here in this great church building, a place of worship and a place which has been a great source of strength and worship to Rose and her family over the years. And we pray you were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. You came to call us in our lives to you. Christ, have mercy. And you plead for us at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Rose, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. So we come now to the liturgy of the word, the passage of scripture chosen for today's Mass. In between both, some music will be played for our responsorial psalm.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, and a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Today, through the strength of heaven, light of sun, radiance of moon, splendor of fire, speed of lightning, swiftness of wind, depth of the sea, stability of earth, firmness of rock. I arise today through God's strength to pilot me, God's eye to look before me, God's wisdom to guide me, God's way to lie before me, God's shield to protect me. From all who shall wish me ill, afar and near, alone and in a multitude.
So now we have our second reading in our Mass this day from the New Testament.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. For us, our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Saviour we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ, and he will transfigure these bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. He will do that with the same power with which he can subdue the whole universe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'm just going to take a short gospel from St. John. We'll just remain seated for this, for your comfort. Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus. It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going out to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I'm going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. If any of us were to sit down for a moment and sum up the journey of life, there are words that would probably be very fitting and appropriate and meaningful. We could describe it as a series of meetings and greetings, rejoicing, working, caring, enjoyment, supporting, achieving, worrying, crying, disappointments, praying. I feel that these and other words would so fit into the journey of all of our lives. And in all its vastness, it's a journey that is unique. It's a journey that's very special. And above all, it's very, very sacred. And that is why we should have profound respect for the individual life. No two people are the same on this earth. The uniqueness of our lives can never be replaced. And that's precisely why we come in sorrow at the loss of a loved one. But with the greatest of respect for Rose, whose journey is now complete, a journey that has both influenced and touched the lives of many others, none more so than her own family. And we come to celebrate her life. We gather before God to give thanks, as I pre-mentioned, for all the many blessings, but most of all, for the very person that she was. You know, at death, there's that sense of loss that you don't feel in any other walk of life, I think. But we're here as well in this church to offer that loss to God and to also offer back to God all our loved ones, to the God who gave them to us in the first place, and to thank him for us having the great honour and privilege of they having been part of our lives. So it is with the greatest of respect that we do this day. We say thanks to Rose, and we say thanks to God. And on that note, I offer the sympathy of the community to all associated with Rose relatives, neighbors, and friends, most particularly her family members. At present, there were 4 generations of the family. Her great-grandchildren, Johnny and Xander. And we think of those, the next generation, who have lost their grandmother, Ivor and Niall and Jamie and Connor and Fiona and Oisín. And her sympathy to her sons-in-law, John and James, and her daughter-in-law, Orla, whom I know there was a very special bond there. And most of all, our sincere sympathy to her family, Martina and Ita and Jarlath. You know, even though we know that this time comes and that we have to let go, nevertheless, your mum is your mum. And she's one of the most special people and parts of your life. And nothing in this world is ever going to replace that. And that's unique, as I say. That's special. And Rose was exceptional, not just to you, but to all of us and to all of this community for many decades. A graceful, discreet, and an exceptional, caring, natured lady. A person who had the great ability to see the greatness of life and lives, and an exceptional ability to know where to be in a supportive way at the right time. Rose has been part of this community for the most part of her life. A person who had a serious way of commitment about her. Whatever she did it well, and could evenly divide her time to all of the necessities of life as she would see them. Family were number one. That's what she did. Her nature, she knew no other than just being a good mother. And she is a mother both by nature and duty, fulfilled the role in an exceptional way. She reared and took pride in your lives, in your activities, in your achievements over the years. She openly welcomed new members to the family along the years, and she adored the next 2 generations that were to follow. Her work in the business was of true commitment, a woman of great knowledge for facts and figures that would be necessary. Outside of her work, her good nature excelled itself, and in herself giving herself to the community. She did that, as we know, in one of the greatest ways, a way of reaching out to those in need. And that was through her commitment in St. Vincent de Paul's society. Here, we know she went far beyond the call of duty, but as I say, had the gift to be in the right place at the right time. Her appearance, we can't let that go. It was one of elegance. She lived in a place called Chirnanog, land of the youth. Always looked so well. And on top of that wonderful appearance was the smile of a very warm individual. And today, my friends, we celebrate the life of a great woman. A woman accompanied with much honesty, kindness, wit, intelligence, and a woman of exceptional faith. It's very appropriate to be here in St. Colman's Church in prayer for her, as this was pretty much her other home across the road. As earlier, we know that she was presented with a Benemerenti medal from Pope John Paul II back in 1999. And that alone speaks volumes of her commitment to God, church, people, and community. Faith was part of the very texture of her life. She knew God, she respected God all her life. She respected the Blessed Mother. The readings there a few moments ago, and particularly the first one, reminding us times allotted for so many things in life. Indeed, she made so much time for the positivity that she had the ability to bring to people and situations. I just chose the gospel from St. John there because Rose indeed through her faith knew so well that one day this was to take place and that the Lord had provided for all of us and for those that she had lost in her own life many rooms in the Father's house and knew that one day it would be her turn. And now we return her to the God whom loves us in life and welcomes us all in death. We can only rejoice for her happiness right now. She witnesses in the presence of God, who was part and parcel of her existence. The happiness of being with friends and family gone before her. The reunion with her husband, Vincent, surrounded by two little angels, Teresa and Fiona. And as I so often say, what we have to focus on now at this time, it's about focusing on a new life, a happy life, an eternal life. The earthly journey is complete, and for Rose, the next one is only beginning. So may she rest in peace. Amen. And we're going to offer up our prayers now for Rose, for all our deceased, for those journeying through bereavement too, others journeying through illnesses, and all who may need our prayers at this time. So invite those who pray in the prayers of the faithful to now join me here in the sanctuary area.
Nanny touched us and the lives of us all in a very special way. In her long life, she was an example to us all. May we strive to copy her virtues, kindness, and listening ears, and so we play our part in making the world a better place. Lord, hear us. We pray for the deceased members of the Sweeney and Prendergast families. We remember especially today Vincent Sweeney, her granddaughter Fiona Cribben, godson Martin O'Brien, and grandnephew Paddy O'Brien. Today, they enjoy the promises of eternal happiness. Lord, hear us. Lord,
we remember with love those who could not be with us today due to COVID-19 travel restrictions. Ivor, Louise and Xander in Canada, Connor and Hannah in the UK, and Johnny and Einar in Iceland. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
we pray today for those who are sick at home or in hospital. Watch over them and their families and bring them healing, light, and peace. Bless and strengthen the family and the carers and all the frontline workers who look after the sick and elderly. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for neighbours, friends, and family. Let no one ever come to you without coming away better and happier. Be the living expression of God's kindness in your face, kindness in your eyes, kindness in your smile, and kindness in warm greeting. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Today we remember in a very special way our beloved Fiona, granddaughter, daughter, sister, niece, cousin, mother, and friend. Fiona passed away just over a year ago. Like her nanny Rosie, whom Fiona loved dearly, we are blessed with the virtues Fiona showed in her short life. Courage, acceptance, love, gratitude, resilience, kindness, and forgiveness. Today, Rosie will be reunited with her granddaughter Fiona in a place where there will be pure love, joy, and happiness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. And we'll sum up these and all of our prayers now as we pray to our Blessed Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. These prayers we make now through Christ our Lord. Amen. So now, my friends, the bread and wine is placed here on the altar. So many, many times during her life, she witnessed that bread and wine being placed on this altar and many others through her faith and attendance to the Mass. Today, they're placed on the altar for Rose as we offer the Mass for the happy repose of her soul. So we pray now, my friends, that our sacrifice, that it may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name for our good and the good of all his church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Rose, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna the highest. You're indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, and make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We pray now that our sacrifice, that it may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name for our good and the good. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaken of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and the many people. We remember Rose, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in death may be one with him now in his resurrection. Remember all of our families and friends who have gone to their eternal rest. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We pray with confidence to God our Father now in the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with each of you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. I eat your body and drink your blood, lest I have condemnation. This is the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Once again, for anybody who's outside or in cars, as always, if you wish to make your way to the main door, and you can receive communion.
To be loved.
So now invite Jarlath on behalf of the family to say a few words.
Thank you, Father Peter.
Do you want to go down?
Thank you, Father Peter. Well, ma'am, we thought you were going to live forever. And in fairness, you made a great stab at it. At times you thought God had forgotten about you, but your time on earth was very worthwhile. You were always there for us, and we miss you dearly. We know that death is as natural as birth, but somehow we don't look at them the same way. To lose somebody close that you've known all of your life, however long or short that may be, it is difficult to bear. When the heartbeat stops, hearts break. Your mother is your mother, and it's hard to let go, but nature dictates and decides. Ma'am lived a long life, very fruitful, dedicated to serving others, be it us as a family, from 60 unbroken years behind the counter in the shop, or through her decades of involvement in the Vincent de Paul. A very astute businesswoman, very efficient bookkeeper, and she had an amazing judge of character. And she did not take fools lightly. Claremorris not only mourns the passing of one of its longest living residents, but also an 850-year direct family bloodline to which the town is named after. A true descendant of Claremorris, the family of Morris de Prendergast, the Welsh Norman knight who resided and ruled the region from Rice Castle. On the 20th of August, 1921, Rosemary Rosie Sweeney Prendergast was one of six children born to Thomas and Mainey Prendergast at Corrie MacManus in Mayo Abbey. It is remarkable that she was born during a pandemic, that is the Spanish flu, and sadly has died during another pandemic, that is the coronavirus. Following her early education at Mayo Abbey National School, where her father was a monitor, she progressed to St. Louis School in Bale, and soon after graduation from there, she began employment with Sweeney and Stanton at the stores as it was then known as Church Street, which is now Dalton Street. She soon caught the eye of my father, Vincent, and they married in 1951, enjoyed a long life together in harmony until Dad's passing in 2010. They worked extremely hard, built up a very successful business until their retirement in 2005. Mam was a woman of tremendous faith. Daily prayer was the normal practice, and she wore out many a set of rosary beads. Her undying faith kept her strong over many life's challenges and sadness, losing her siblings, her godson Martin O'Brien, her husband, her granddaughter Fiona, just over a short year ago. Every year, the pilgrimage to Loch Derg was looked forward to and seen as a break. That was her holiday. Not everybody could say the same about that, and even on some occasions, she used to go to Pettigore twice in the one season. That, along with a regular attendance at night vigils in Knock, was her unique downtime. The only holidays she used to get was maybe a week at the Galway races, and she was quite satisfied with that. She was never on a plane, never on a boat, or never abroad. She was quite happy in her old world with her own people. Her voluntary work with the Vincent de Paul was most rewarding, although Mam never wanted or wished for any praise or recognition for a lifetime of service to those in need. And she was discreetly very proud, however, on receiving the Bene Minatori Medal in 1999 from Pope Paul II for her dedication and services. And remember, on that occasion, we had to tell a few white lies to get her to the actual presentation ceremony in Mass that evening. Even after she retired from the Vincent, as she called it, the knock would still be heard on the back door of her house, and she never failed to help out. Of course, I'm sure you're anxious to know what the secret is for a long and healthy life. Well, together with a cup of hot water, usually half an hour before breakfast, actually before she went to Mass, she also swore by the magic potion of oil of ulay. She loved her treats and always ate in moderation and never late into the evening. She loved her full-fat milk, full-fat butter, cream, chocolate, apple tart, fruitcake, you name it, she loved it. It was all part of her staple diet, but she actually never showed it. And she always had a fair and soft complexion. And really, I'm not sure how the olive ulay worked, but we think apart from dabbling a drop or two onto her face, she must have really sipped a drop or two as well. Mam never went out without her scarf, a quick dab of lipstick, and a good shower of hairspray. That was her forte. During the course of her latter years of life, Mam was looked after very lovingly and caringly by a number of Florence Nightingales, as I call them, who looked after her every year with great attention and is really much appreciated. A special thanks to her regular visitors and also to Dr. Murray Jr. and Sr. and the team at the Knock Medical Centre, to Martina and Caroline, the public health nurses, to Flynn's Pharmacy, Martha Gilligan and Father Peter, and Father Martin O'Connor for their excellent services. And also thanks to Olive, the occupational therapist. As we all know, coronavirus has changed the way we live and society in general. And we cannot have a funeral in the traditional way as we're accustomed to. And we really appreciate the messages of sympathy and support received, which is very consoling to us. And thank you, one and all. Thanks also to our wonderful neighbours and friends who helped and supported us in every way and for the food that was prepared for us. And also to Mammy's Vincent de Paul friends who kept in touch with her over the years. Many have described Mam as a mighty woman. Well, the mighty and the almighty are together now. Together in peace, in the arms of her family, in heaven. Her abiding words were, be wise, be careful, and be kind. And they'll remain with us forevermore. Farewell, Mam. We love you. Keep an eye on us from above. And Mam, you had amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that thought my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace has brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope, seek yours. He will my shield and portion be, as long as life endures. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was blind, but now I see.
And let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Rose may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we come to a close, and we'll be coming in a moment to the prayers of accommodation, can I say thank you to everybody who's been involved in the liturgy, and of course, because of a number of restrictions, that nearly includes everybody in the church. And Jarlath, for your lovely words of tribute to your mom, and I appreciate that's not an easy thing to come up here for speak about any family member, but particularly about your mum. Jamie, what a great voice to share with us today. And I'm sure this woman was very proud and is very proud of you. And to all who've done readings and prayers of the faithful, and did it in a very respectful way. During the prayers of commendation, we will bless the coffin with holy water, and then we will have the incense as a mark of respect, using it to symbolize the offering up of our prayers this day for Rose. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of Rose. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And the response we pray, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take her to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she receive her soul, present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Rose, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise again with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with all of our loved ones forever. So my friends, now in peace, we will take Rose to her place of rest.
There were people of all ages gathered round the gate. Children that you call, we are gathered here before you, and our hearts are just the same, filled with joy at such a vision as we praise your name. Golden
message was unspoken, but in truth in silence lies. So I gaze upon your vision, and the truth I try to find. Here I stand with John the teacher, and with Joseph at your side, and I see the Lamb of God on the altar glorified. Golden Rose, Queen of Ireland, all my cares and troubles cease as we will shine.